3406.
This is Hera Geeky 1, Echo Bravo Echo from Greece, and welcome back to my channel. As you can see, I'm talking to you through my mobile phone, which is connected to an external antenna and a circuit. I thought I could do this video backward this time, so I do the transmission test first, and we'll talk to you about it later. So, the circuit board I'm talking to you from is kv4p, Windows Vector for Papa, and it's an open source project. You can find it on GitHub and they have a website. I'll show you all about it in a second. And as you can see, it turns my smartphone in a VHF mobile rating, which is amazing, if you ask me. Of course, the power is kind of limited, but this is an amazing option to have with you and tap your mobile phone in a VHF transmitter. So let me head back to my laptop and I'll talk to you about this project from there.
And this is me talking back from my mobile phone to the QuantSec TK11. My mobile phone now works as a transmitter, a VHF transmitter, and I'll be right there with you in a second.
Right. So let me show you what's going on here. This is an open source project that I stumbled upon and I thought it was amazing. I believe that this is what ham radio is about. It's a project called kv4p HT. It's Kilo Victor 4 Papa. It started from Vance Vagel, which is Kilo Victor 4 Papa. And what this does is that it takes some components like an ESP32 microcontroller, a VHF transceiver, and connects them from a newly designed circuit board to a really small and portable VHF transceiver. I have to say this again, this is what ham radio is about. Innovation, do-it-yourself projects and hacking. Now, this is my smartphone. This is an application written for this project in Android. And here is the module. It has also designs for 3D printed cases. Here it is, KV4P HT. The new version, this is version 2. The new version that is sold as pre-assembled from AliExpress. It also has a PTT button here. The older versions didn't have that. And as you can see, I can control it either by my smartphone pressing here as a PTT or using the PTT up here. Now, I have put it with some band on my phone, but it arrives with a sticker. I'll just show you all of these components in a second. This is the application. Let's have a look here, a quick look. As you can see, I can put frequencies in VHF band. It has options. You can put your call sign here. You select VHF or UHF module. The boards that are sold at the moment and designed are VHF modules, so don't use the UHF option, as far as I know, as I say again, at this moment. Some options here for filtering, PTT, and of course it has APRS, which is another amazing thing that this thing can do. You can turn it on, it will transmit your location, you can select approximate location or exact, and here you can select options about the bandwidth, minimum and maximum megahertz that it can transmit. And that's about it. I mean, it's a pretty simple application. I don't know what to say about it. It's simple and amazing. So I'm going to disassemble this thing to show you what exactly came to me when I ordered it from AliExpress. I'm also going to put links, of course, in the description for the AliExpress shop that sells those things pre-assembled or disassembled in order to solder them yourself, but I would recommend to get the pre-assembled version. Let me take off the rubber band. Just be careful not to destroy anything. I'll talk to you about the cable and the adapter here in a second. I will disconnect it. Right, we have here a small rubber antenna that comes with the module when you order it. This arrived to me and I guess to everyone else who orders it from AliExpress as pre-assembled module like this. So it has already the 3D printed case although the designs are online in the kv4p website and on GitHub, but this arrived like this. Here's a QR code for the website, kv4p.com. As you can see, let me zoom here. Okay, it says kv4p HD version 20D. It has a date of 15th January 2025. And it's the new circuit board, as I said, the redesigned one. There is also the version 1. It doesn't have the PTT button here. It's simpler, but it still works just fine. And let me show you how it looks inside. I'll take off the 3D printed case carefully. There's no need for you to do this. Okay. Here's the circuit board. This is the ESP32 microcontroller. In here there's the firmware that is flashed. I'll show you how it's done. And this is what really does all the control of the radio. It connects to your mobile phone, to Android, and does all the programming and instructions. And this is the VHF transceiver. All nicely assembled in a new circuit board, really cared with design, and it works amazingly. Just imagine that with this small thing, it's almost like a big lighter. You can have this in your pocket, connect it to your smartphone, and you have a VHF transceiver. Just like that. Of course, the power is kind of limited, but still, look at this. I mean, it's amazing. Okay, so I'll put it back here. Perfect. Now, just to compare the size of it, this is my smartphone, a Samsung Galaxy Note 10. This is the size of the KV4P. When it arrived, it was the module with the 3D printed case on, the antenna, and the sticker that you can put here, and it's Velcro. You can put the other side to your mobile phone and take it on and off as you like. So, this is the KV4P website, kv4p.com. If you go here, all the information you need, it's right here. Here are the features. 22 kHz 8-bit ADC-DAC radio with filters and squelch. Texting with notifications, just like SMS, radio-based APRS messaging, not just location, with built-in 1200 baud modem. Scan through unlimited memories and groups. No battery, because it connects to your phone. 1 watt transmit, which of course takes a toll to your smartphone battery, but again, we know about this. And accessibility options like turn off animations, sticky PTT, and other things like that. All this project is completely open source. It's GPL3, it's on GitHub, everything is on GitHub, the source code, the designs for the 3D print case, the board, anything you need. There is a very active community in Discord, and also in this website you will find videos that will help you. If you want to build it yourself, the components of the boards are here, a way to 3D print a case for it, the Android app, which I would suggest not to use the Play Store version, but to use the GitHub version. Download the APK from here and sideload it to your phone, because I had some problems with the Play Store version. I don't know, maybe it wasn't updated. Now, let me tell you something else about this device. When it arrived, it had a USB-C to USB-C cable, a small black cable to connect it directly from here to your mobile phone, to your Android phone. I had a lot of problems with those cables. I had continuous disconnections. Also, another part of the problems was the Play Store app, the older version that I installed. But I had a lot of problems mainly with the USB cable. What I discovered after a lot of trial and error is that you have to get a good quality cable capable of data transfer with one USB-C connector and one standard USB connector, and use one of these adapters that might have come with your phone, with your Android phone. This is an aftermarket one, but I remember also having one with my Samsung smartphone. This is an OTG adapter. You can search for it if you don't know what it is. It's called On The Go. It has a small circuit board in here that tells the smartphone that you have to give 5 volt power to the device connected to this adapter. So you put this on the standard USB and you connect this end to the Android smartphone and this end here to the module, to the kv4p module. Let's see how this works. And I'll show you also what happens when you connect your smartphone with the module for the first time. So the instructions that I'm giving are from some trial and errors that I made, so you won't make them. When you first install the app, just open and close it a few times to get all the permissions needed for the app to function correctly. GPS permission, notification permissions and stuff like that. It doesn't work out of the box. Do one or two openings of the app so it will get all the permissions that it needs from the Android system. And let's plug in the OTG adapter. Now, when the device is new, as it arrives, it will give you this message: no firmware installed, flash now. All you have to do is press flash now and it will start passing the latest firmware in the KV4P module. You just have to wait a bit. Let's see. It will give you some instructions here, but as you can see, it already started flashing. And it's done. Let's do a reconnect. If you see this message, radio module not responding to ESP32, check PCB solder, just leave it for a few seconds. Don't panic. As you can see, it went away. That's because the ESP32 board needs some time to boot. Of course, if this message stays on the screen a long time, then maybe your PCB board has some problem and some solderings are off and it's a problematic module. But if it stays on for a few seconds, then don't worry, don't panic. Give it some time for the device to boot and the phone will find it.
Είσαι κατανοητός στο 100%. Η διαμόρφωσή σου είναι πολύ καλή. Έχεις ένα αφήσιμα. Κουβαλάς ένα αφήσιμα, ένα θορυβάκι, ένα 30%-35%, το οποίο δεν επηρεάζει πουθενά σε τίποτα. Ακούγεσαι δηλαδή μια χαρά.
Ευχαριστώ και πάλι για τη δοκιμή. Αν θυμάμαι καλά, Sierra Victor 1, Oscar Mike... Oscar Mike κάτι μου είπες τώρα. Για πες μου λίγο το διακριτικό, να σε καλά, από Sierra Yankee 1, Echo Bravo Echo.
Echo Bravo Echo, είμαι Oscar Uniform Victor, έτσι, Sierra Victor 1, Oscar Uniform Victor, νότια προάστια αυτή τη στιγμή, περιοχή Αργυρούπολη, Mobile, όνομα Θανάση.
Να είσαι καλά, Θανάση. Νίκος από Σκιάθο αυτή τη στιγμή, Sierra Yankee 1, Echo Bravo Echo, κάθετος 8. Και πάλι ευχαριστώ, 73.
Καλή συνέχεια, καλή συνέχεια. Να είσαι καλά. Ποιο είναι αδελφός, ο διακόπτης.
Σε Θανάση, καλησπέρα. Καλησπέρα και στον Νίκο από Σκιάθο. Ο Νικόλας, είμαι ο Sierra Yankee 1, Δέλτα Βίκτορ Πάπα.
Καλησπέρα μου, την καλησπέρα μου και από μένα, από Echo Bravo Echo, κάθετος 8, Νικόλα.
Καλησπέρα και από μένα, Δέλτα Βίκτορ Πάπα, καλησπέρα.
Καλησπέρα και στους δύο, καλησπέρα. Νικόλα, περνάει, το μοντούλι, ναι, περνάει, περνάει, με λίγο φύσμα, αλλά περνάει, μια χαρά.
Είναι αυτό το κολπάκι, η πλακέτα που κάνει το κινητό ασύρματο. Ετοιμάζω ένα βιντεάκι τώρα για το κανάλι και
το δοκιμάζω εδώ στο νησί. Έχω και μια κεραία custom made από καλώδιο, αλλά είναι με 1,5W, δεν πάει παραπάνω.
Έλα ναι, έλα ναι Νικόλα μου, κατανοητός είστε όμως, κατανοητός. Για τέτοιο πράγμα καλά είναι πιστεύω, κατανοητός είστε. Στην Ιχάδα μπαίνεις ή κάτω απευθείας?
Μπαίνω απευθείας, απευθείας. Από Σκιάθο υπάρχει μια τρύπα τέλος πάντων που περνάει πάνω από τα βουνά. Την έχω τσεκάρει και με διάφορα όργανα και βγαίνει ακριβώς στο Πανελλαδικό στην Αθήνα.
After that, the operation of the application is pretty simple. You can input your frequencies here. If you have a frequency set here, you can add it to the memory list, adding a name here, maybe choosing a memory group. This is the frequency. If it's a repeater, you can set up the offset direction, minus or plus. If it needs a tone, you can set it here. Here is the offset in kilohertz, and if you want to skip this memory during scan. Pretty straightforward, pretty simple to use, and that's why I love this project. I would say that if you're a radio enthusiast, a ham operator, and you like this kind of do-it-yourself projects or gadgets, go grab one and have it with you to play with. Now, the cost of this module, I didn't mention anything about the cost of this module. In AliExpress, in the AliExpress store that I shopped it, in the AliExpress store that I got it from, it's around 50 euros for the version 1 module board and around 63 to 64 euros for the version 2 board. I would suggest, of course, to go for the version 2 board if it's not too steep a price for you. It's really upgraded and better designed, and it also has a pretty handy PTT button here. As you can see, I press it and it opens the PTT in the phone. So, really helpful. At this point, I really should say thank you to Vance Fagel for this project, for starting this project, and to all the guys that have contributed to it. PCP design, application design, code refactoring, and also to the AppTech store in AliExpress that helped me in order to review this module. Before closing this video, I'll just do a power test to this module just for the fun of it. I mean, it's about 1 and 2 watts, but still, I'll just do the power test to have a look. Okay, let me take off the antenna. And have the power meter here. Okay, with a set frequency of 144.55 megahertz, let's see if I press PTT, what do we have in watts? 1.47. Oh, okay, it's above 1 watt from what the site says. 1.5 watts from this tiny module. I would say this is excellent for pocket operation. This is it for this video. KV4P project. Check the links in the description if you want to grab one. This is here again, Yankee 1 Echo Bravo Echo. Thank you for watching. See you next time.